Hello students, today we will be taking Unit 2 of Human Resource Management. The contents include career and succession planning, job analysis and role description, methods of manpower search, attracting and selecting human resource. The first topic include career planning. Now, we'll see what is career planning. Career planning is a sequence of position held by a person during the course of lifetime. So, career planning is a process where we see the number of position an individual perceives during his career, during his lifetime. Now, we'll come to the second point. A career is a sequence of separate but related work activities that provide continuity, order and meaning in person's life. So a career planning is a sequence, we go in a sequence but separate but related work activities. We do a work that is similar but they are related to each other, they are separate but related to each other, and they provide continuity in your career. Now we'll come to the third point. Career planning is a process of systematically matching your career goals and individual capabilities with opportunities for their fulfillment. Now, in career planning, your career goals and your individual opportunities should always match. These are the three main definitions of career planning. Now we'll come to the need of the career planning. Why we require career planning? First, it provides career goals and path. It helps you to choose your career goal and the path to fulfill that goals. Now, second, develop competencies. With the help of career planning, you will be able to know what kind of skills you require, what kind of trainings you require for fulfilling your career goal. Now, comes the third point. It helps in developing the employee to make them ready for future challenges. With the help of career planning, you are being prepared for the upcoming challenges. It helps to retain the employee. Fifth, it helps to motivate the employee. Sixth, it reduces dissatisfaction and turnover. Your dissatisfaction decreases and turnover. Next is it improves morale. Your morale get improved with the help of career planning. Now we comes to the career anchors. Career anchors are the distinct patterns of self-perceived talents, attitudes, motives and values that guides and stabilizes a person's career after several years of real world experiences. So career anchors are the various attitudes, your talents, your motives, your values, your skills that helps you to choose your career. So 8 anchors are there. Let's see first anchor, that is managerial competence. Managerial competence can be said the person who are having the skills of dealing with the people, are good at leadership skills, they can work in teams, they can handle teams. The person who are expertise in managerial skills. Now comes the technical competence. Technical competence include the technical skill of an individual. Technical skill in something, like we say in teaching, in engineering. We require technical skills. Now we come to the security. Security means a stability in your career. A person who is looking forward for the stability in their job require a job where they are secured, they don't want challenges, they are seeking a job that is more stable. They go for 9 to 5, we can say they go for 9 to 5 jobs. They don't want new opportunities. They go for the prescribed level of promotions, level of trainings. So security is a anchor where you look forward with stability in your job. Now comes the creativity. A person looking forward with the creativity as an anchor is creative. he loves art. He is more thoughtful, like we can say artistic people, like fashion designers. So they are having this career anchor. Now we go for the autonomy. Autonomy means independence. A person who is looking forward with this career anchor do not like rules, policies, regulations, dress codes. So they want independence in their job. They want to rule by their own. So the person looking with this career anchor love to go with the business, doing their own businesses. They don't want the ruling part. They don't want bossism. Now we come to the dedication. Dedication to cause is again a career anchor that for people who are working for the reason of cause, reason of development of something, like inventors, like scientists. Now it comes to the pure challenges. A person looking forward with this particular challenge, pure challenge as in career anchor includes, they go for the challenges, they go for the new opportunities. They don't want monotonous life, like we can say the example we include army people, police, the people who are in CIDs, the navies, they go for the pure challenges as a career anchor. Now, lifestyle is a career anchor where people look forward for the family and job, a base in balance in the family as well as job. As in career, they go for flexibility. They don't want kind of rigidness. So lifestyle is a career anchor where we want work-life balance. Now we'll come to the next. A next slide, that is career stages. Career stages includes of a person is the age and his performance. Now we this graph shows that the age includes 0 to 25 years of age, 25 to 35 years of age, 35 to 50 years of age, 50 to 60, and 60 to 70. Now we see the first phase, that is the exploration phase, that is from college to work. A person who is going from he is going towards the first job, towards the work. So this is a phase where a person is going for his choosing his career, his stream, his subject, his field in which he want to go, who he want to move in his career, he want his career. So this is the exploration phase where you take help of your friends, you take guidance from your teachers, your friends, your parents, that which career should I choose. Now comes the second phase, that is the establishment phase, that is in you are in the age of 25 to 35 years of age, and this is a phase where you get a new job, where you get your first job. Here your phase is more towards learning. Your face is more towards making mistakes and then correcting them. This is it. Basically, this phase is a learning phase. Then comes the age group of the 35 to 50, that is your mid-career phase, where you are now established in your career. You have perfectly chosen in which career you want to stay, in which field you want to stay, and now you are moving towards giving the performance. Now, if your performance decreases, then this is a decline of your career, and if your performance increases, then you are going to your boom of your career. So this is a fair phase where you need to look forward towards more opportunities. You should look more towards the training smart. You should develop yourself so that you can get more number of promotions. Your career path, your career graph can should move towards heights. Now we'll come to the age of 50 to 60, that is the late career stage, where you are elderly state person, Now you don't want new challenges. You are into your base career. You work in your field, and now you don't want new work to new challenges in your life. So this is again a state where you can be a guide, guidance people as a guide. You can be a mentor to the people, to the others who are into the basement, into their first careers, and you can guide them. Now comes the last stage of this career stages, is this retirement phase, where now you are done with your careers, you are done what you want in your life. Now you are moving towards the retirement phase, that is the decline phase of your career. Now we comes to the career planning process. First, we'll see again the definition of career planning. Career planning is a process by which one selects a career goal and the path for the goal. Now we see the steps that is taken for career planning process. First, identify individual needs and aspirations. By first point is the identifying needs. Need is the type of career you want to choose, your requirement, your area of interest, by for choosing your career. And the aspirations is the part, aspirations is the part of the area of interest, the way you want to choose your career, the things that attracts you. So individual needs and aspirations. Then comes the analyzing career opportunities. Now after choosing your need with the path, the career you want to choose, then you will select the opportunities. Do I have the opportunities in the career that I have chosen? Then we align the needs and the opportunities. We will match our needs and the opportunities by in the third step. Then we need go for the action plan and periodic review. Action plan and periodic review includes that the career that you have chosen, you are moving into the right direction, you are taking proper steps, you are taking proper workshops, you are taking proper training, so that you do not get a gap in your career. You are moving into the right direction. So these are the four points of career planning process. Now we come to the career development. This is the another topic of career planning, career development. Career development consists of persons' actions one undertake to achieve a career plan. What all things a person does to achieve a career plan is the career development. Career development includes individual career development, a person himself, what he do for it, his own career planning. And second one is the organization career development, that includes what organization do for your career planning, for your development. This go hand in hand by together. Now first we'll see the individual career development. Individual career development is the first point, include your performance. If you want a good career development, then you should go for your performance. You should check continuously how you are performing, where your graph is moving. It's going into the decline phase, or it moving into the for in into the expansion phase, moving towards the heights. So now comes the second point, exposure. How exposed you are in your sector, how much you are opportunistic in your sector is the exposure. Now comes the networking. How is your network within your organizations, within different peoples, within different committees, how your network is strong. Now comes the leverage. Leverage is it engage in oneself in the work. So keeping your organization into the top priorities is the leveraging part. Now comes the loyalty to career. If you want a career development, then you should be loyal to your career. like leaving job within 2 months or a year is not good. So your development will be not good. If you go with the if you keep yourself retain yourself for a long period of time, then chances of career development increases. This is the loyalty to your career. You should be loyal to your words your career. Now comes the mentors or sponsors. Mentors is a person who guides you in your career, who trains you, guides you, gives you the direction. And sponsor is a person who gives you financial assistance for your career. Now comes the key subordinates. Key subordinate is a person who gives you guidance. Your subordinate gives you guidance for your career. Now comes the expandability. Expandability means you have an position, you are in a position that you expand yourself. You should have an ability to grab the opportunities, not to be narrow in your area. You should go for the new areas, get new expertise so that you expand yourself. These are the points that are covered in individual career development. Now we come to the organization career development. Organization career development includes organization needs to design and implement career development program for their employees. What organization does for the employee for their career development? First includes the self-assessment tools. Self-assessment tools is the checking of an organization checks the potential of employee, and then they follow various self-assessment tools like to increase their skills, their interests, their competencies, which helps them to know their likes and dislikes. Now comes the career planning workshops and workbooks. This is the platform where the organization provide you various workshops, trainings, various seminar opportunities and various manuals, workbooks to improve yourself. Individual counseling is the one-to-one counseling where individual is counseled to know their potential, to know their gap, and this helps to develop an individual. Now comes the organization assessment programs. Organization assessment programs include the assessment centers, psychological test, promo ability forecast, 360 degree appraisals. Now comes the development programs. Development programs is the developing individuals through trainings, job rotations, seminars, mentor programs, etc. Next comes the career planning for special groups. Special groups are the people who are very much expertise, have potential, so organization invest their time and money to develop themselves for higher positions and develop go for the career, their career development. Even special groups include dual career couples. Dual career couples are the people where the woman and the men both are working in the family, both are working, and organization look forward that they we can maintain a proper work balance by providing them flexible working hours, by providing them work from homes, maternity leaves to them, so that they can perform better in the organizations. These are the points that are covered in the organization career development. Now we come to the another topic, that is succession planning. By succession planning is a process of identifying, develop, and to make people ready to occupy higher level of job in the organization. So it's very easy. Like succession planning is a process by which we identify and develop people. We look forward for the people who are good, who have potential in them, So we develop them, we train them for the higher positions in the organization, so that we do not take people from outside the organization. We take people, we recruit people for higher position from within the organization. This is succession planning. Again, we see the next definition. Organization appraise the employee potentials, identify training gaps for future vacancies, develop them for higher and varied job. Now, we come to the another topic, that is recruitment. Recruitment is a process of finding and hiring best qualified candidate. So it's very clear that recruitment is a process of finding a people and hiring them for hiring best qualified candidate from within or outside the organization for a job opening in timely and cost effective manner. So it should be done on timely basis and cost effective manner. Now, second definition, it is a process of finding and attracting capable applicant for the employment. The process begins when new recruits are sought and ends when the applicants are submitted. The result is a pool of applicants from which we new employees are selected. So result is what? When we get the number of pools of candidate for the applied position. So we can say recruitment is a positive process. Now we come to the next that is challenges of recruitment. Challenges of recruitment include poor image. A company that is having a poor image has a very negative impact, negative recruitment process. They face negative recruitments. They face a number of problems by recruiting the employee because no one want to go in the organization that is having a poor image. Unattractive job that is unattractive, that is not liked by number of people is again very difficult to fill the positions. Limited budget, if the organization gives the less budget and we need to hire a people, then again it's a big problem. Now, attracting the right candidate, it's very difficult to attract the right candidate because among the pool of candidates, selecting people is very difficult. Hiring fast, again, this is a problem for recruitment hiring. We hire a people very fast. Building strong brand image, it's again a very difficult. You need to build your image, you need to brand image, you need to give your image brand branding, you need to show your branding. If you show good brand, then people will automatically attract by your brand and will come for the recruitments for joining your company. Now, recruiting fairly. Now, this is the point where recruitment should be done in a fair manner. False recruitments and with the source recruitments is a big challenge for the HR professionals. Now comes the using data driven recruitment. When we get a data that is not proper, so it's very difficult to get a person that is well qualified for this particular position. Now we comes to the process of recruitment. Process of recruitment includes define recruitments, includes the job description and the job specification. Then comes the attracting pool candidate, that is job advertisement. Then the select right people, job interview and ability test. Job description includes the whole description of your job, the tasks, duties, your responsibilities, what has to be done, what need to be done is the job description. Specification is a qualification required for the particular job. Next, track potential candidate is through job advertisement, or we can see the methods of recruitment where with the help of which we fill the position. Now we comes the select the right people. This is the job interview or the test we follow or the company follows. This is the process of recruitment. Now we comes to the method of recruitment. There are two methods of recruitment. First is the internal recruitment and next is the external recruitment. Let's see internal recruitment. Internal recruitment means like promotions. We give promotion to our employees, transfers, job postings and employee referrals. Now we come to the next, that is external recruitments includes campus recruitments, advertisements, newspaper ads, television and radio, private employee search engines, outsourcing, poaching, web publishing and management consultants. Again, the recruitment includes the modern recruitment methods, that is social media, putting requirement on the official websites, talent search, using recruitment agencies. These are the methods to which we can recruit people. Now we comes with the advantages and disadvantage of recruitment. The internal recruitment have advantages, includes advantage like cheaper and quicker. Disadvantage includes limits the number of potential applicants. People already familiar with the business and how it operates. No new idea can be introduced from outside the business. Provides opportunity for promotion in the business, can be motivating, may cause resentment among candidates not appointed. Resentment means kind of dissatisfaction. Can be attained as the person who is promoted is satisfied, while the others who are not promoted will feel bad. Now we come to the next point. Business already knows the strength and weakness of the candidate. Creates another vacancy which needs to be filled. Again, if you are filling the higher position, so one position is again left to be filled. Now we comes to the external recruitment advantages and disadvantages. External recruitment include outside people bring new ideas, long process. Large pool of workers from which to find the best candidate. It is expensive process. People have wide range of experiences. Selection process may not be effective or enough to reveal the best candidate. These are the disadvantages. Now we come to the another topic, that is selection. Now, selection is a process of choosing the most suitable candidate for the vacant position in the organization. Like we have studied, recruitment is a process where we attract the pool of candidates, large pool of candidates we attract for the required position. Now in selection, we choose from those pool of candidate, we choose the best candidate for the organization. So selection means weeding out unsuitable applicants and selecting those individuals with prerequisite qualification capabilities to fill the jobs in the organization. Now we comes with to the selection process. Selection process first include preliminary interview round. Preliminary interview round includes the simple round of HR where you have been asked the basic questions, your introduction, your strength, your weakness. It is not the deeper interview. It is a simple interview round taken to know yourself. Now receiving the applications. Receiving the application is a kind of a document that you need to fulfill, where your app name, where the whole draft of that will be explaining about your career opportunities, about your previous organization you worked, your experiences, your achievements. You will be putting all those in that particular document. Questions it includes, and you attach your resume along with that. Now comes the screening of applicants. The people who have filled these application forms, you screen the application forms, you scrutinize the application forms, that is fulfilling the required position requirements. Now comes the employment test. Employment test is the test where you take the basic test rounds, where it can be a logical reasoning test, English aptitude test, GDs, group discussions you can take written round. With the help of this, you will be scrutinizing, you will be more scrutinizing the people who are not fit, best fit for the that particular job. Then comes the employment interview round. Employment interview round is the round where now your basic round is clear. Now you will be dealing with your technical specialized area. Now the HR will be asking you the deeper questions that is related to your work, related to your subject, to make them more, make him understand that you are fit for that particular position or not. Now comes the checking references. Checking references is that the where you been checked with your reference, the people whom you know, so that the HR may get the better understanding that the how you are, how with how you worked in the previous organization, what kind of a person you are. Then comes the physical examination. Physical examination do not take place in every interview round. It depend upon the requirement of the job. Then comes the final selection. If you are through with all these rounds, then you get the final offer letter. This is the steps that are taken in selection process. Now we comes to the next topic of this unit, that is interview. Interview refers to the format formal in-depth conversation between two or more persons, wherein exchange of information takes place with view of checking candidate acceptability for the job. So it's an in-depth conversation between the two people where the exchange of information takes place, so that we can check the person is suited for the particular job or he is not suited for the particular job. Next point we can see, an interview is a purposeful exchange of ideas, the answers of questions, and communication between two or more persons. Now we see the types of interview. First is the preliminary interview. As I have made you clear in selection also, preliminary interview is the basic interview round where a HR want to know about yourself. He gains information about you. It's a basic interview round. Now the depth interview round. Depth interview round is again an interview round where you get a detailed subject knowledge, detailed your expertise is checked. Now comes the stress interview round. Here this is the round where the your stress level is checked with the help of various management games, various exercises, various techniques through which an HR checks how you can handle the stress. Panel interview round is the interview round where the people one or more people sit together and take the interview. Telephonic interview round, by the name it's clear that you have been interviewed with the help of telephone. Now comes the structured interview or the patterned interview. Structured interview is interview round where the sequence of questions are structured. They have been ranked with from the easy to the hardest. Then unstructured interview round is the round where the sequence of questions are random. They can be asked tough, tough or easy, easy or tough. Randomly, any question can be asked to you. Now comes the one-to-one interview round. An interviewer and the interviewee are sit together and they take interview. The interview has been taken one-to-one. Case interview is a round where the you have given the case and you need to solve the case, and according to your analysis of the case, the interviewer checks how you can be suited for the particular position. Now the meantime interview round is a round we your behavior skills, your dining skills are checked at the time of meal. Behavioral based interview rounds are the behavioral questions asked to you, behavioral exercises done with you so that you can be checked. Then comes the exit interview round, is the round where is round when you leave the organization. This is a round to check the why the person is leaving. Is he facing any problem in the organization, or he is getting some new opportunities? So what is the reason behind he is leaving the organization? To know this reason, we take exit interview round. Now comes the group interview. Group interview is a round where we take the interview in a group of people. It can be all people are sitting together, and interviewer takes your interview one by one, but all the people listens you. Then it can be a GD. So these are the points that are being covered in the types of interview. Now we see the interview do's, what we should do when you are going for the interview. First, dress appropriately. Extremes in fashion or very casual clothes should generally be avoided. Look neat and clean. Second, be punctual. Make sure that you are 10 minutes early, and if you are going to unavoidably delay, ring and let them know. Third, express yourself and your views clearly. Bring a copy of all relevant documents so you can refer to them if necessary. Next, listen carefully to the question and answers clearly and thoughtfully. Next, make eye contact. Remember to talk to the person, not to the top right hand corner of the room or at the shoes. Next point, make sure you fully understand the question and query, any point about which you may be doubtful. Next, if you're being interviewed by panel, ensure that you direct your answer to the person who asks the question while still including the other interviewers by making brief eye contact. Next, ask question. Selection is two-way process. They select you, but you also selects them. Next, be aware of what you need so as you can assess how well company can fulfill them. Be confident. Remember that you applied for the position because you thought that you could do it. Show enthusiasm for the company and the position. Remember that they already like you. Employer don't interview employee. They only interview those people who they think have right skills and experience to succeed in position. Consequently, in the interview, you maintain and improve and positive image that you have already created. Next point, make sure that you always present your skills in a positive light. Even when describing your weakness, you should always show them what you are doing to rectify it. Make sure that you have an idea about where you want to be in future and can relate the future goals to your application for the present positions. You must be able to answer the question where you want to be in life after 5 years. Now comes the interview don'ts. These are very important. Don't dress too casually or too untidy. Next point, don't make derogatory remarks about past or present employers. Don't fidget or tidget, which try to control other nervous mannerisms. Conversely, don't sit there like a statue. If you feel more comfortable talking with the aid of your hands for emphasizes, then use them, but don't try to excessive in your gestures. Don't interrupt the interviewer because they have finished asking before they have finished asking you a question, and never finish their sentences for them. Don't lie. These are the points that taken for interview don'ts. Next, don't worry if you answer one question badly. Don't talk about salaries, holidays, bonuses unless they bring them up. Don't answer question with a simple yes or no. Make sure that you explain your reasoning fully. Don't wear too much perfume or aftershave. Don't smoke even if invited to do so. Now we come to the next topic of this unit, that is job analysis. So job analysis in human resource management refers to the process of identifying and determining the duties, responsibilities and specification of given job. Detailed study of a job is known as job analysis, where we determine the person's duties, his responsibilities and their specification for the job. So let's see the basic terms that we see in job analysis. First is element. Element is the smallest unit into which work can be divided. Our work can be divided into smallest units is an element. Task, distinct work activities carried out for distinct purpose. Various activities a person carries in his work is the task. Duty is the number of tasks a people perform. Position refers to the number of duties you perform in your organization. Job, group of positions that are similar as a kind and level of work is the job. Job family includes a series of jobs involving work, same nature but requiring different level of skills and responsibilities. Like job family includes, you are doing the various number of jobs that are same in nature but require different skills. Now comes the occupation. Occupation is someone's jobs. Like if George Bush is asked what is your occupation, he may say he is a president. Now career. Career is composed of job held titles earned and work accomplished over a long period of time, rather than just referring the one positions. The sequence of positions held by an individual during his lifetime is a career. Now comes the Now comes the steps in the job analysis. The steps in the job analysis includes the collection of background of information. Collection of background and information, what kind of information is required to study the job is the first point. Then comes the selection of representative position to be analyzed. Which position we are analyzing for the job analysis. Then comes the collection of job analysis data. Then comes the developing of job descriptions. And then comes the job specification. Let's see the first point, collection of background information. Like what information, background information is the back information you required for the particular job analysis, for the roles, responsibilities that will be required for the certain job. Then selecting the representative position, which position you are analyzing. Like if we are analyzing the position of a teacher, so the background information includes the what kind of work she might be doing, what are the activities she does. Then comes the representative position analysis, the teaching job. Then comes the collection of the job analysis data. Now we will collect the data from various sources, like we can collect from the the prospective teacher, or by their boss, by their documents, by their course materials, the list of the things they list of the tasks they perform in their career. Then comes a job description. Job description includes the total number of the tasks, duties, responsibilities she does, what need to be done, how it is to be done, includes the job description, and the specification includes the education required, the skill required for the particular job. Teaching like maths teacher require that she should be maths graduate. Now comes the methods of job analysis. Methods first include is the individual interview method, where we analyze the job analysis. We do the job analysis by interviewing the individual. We get the information of the job from the individual itself. Next comes the group interview method. This can be done with the interviewing the group of people, the how the work is done and how we analyze the job. Structured questionnaire method is the with the help of certain number of questions we get the information. Technological method includes the with the help of technology we get the information of the job. The diary method is the person who maintains the diary. We take the help of that particular diary, the task the person do in her routine work, and we get the information. Observation method is a process where we observe people, where we see them, we by looking at their work we can get to know the task they perform, the work they perform. Now comes the sample of job analysis. We can see this is a sample of job analysis that includes the information area and the contents. This includes the job title and the location, organizational relationships, relation to other jobs, job summary, and information concerning job requirements. Like job title and location includes the counter clerk. And the his location is the packed food stuff division. Organizational relationship is that he possesses 8 colleagues and supervised by Mr. Samsam. Relation to other jobs is the price of item clear for cashiers. When item inventory reduces to specific level, manager inventory need to be informed. Then shelf arrangement. Job summary includes assisting customer in selecting need item, right behavior customer to ensure the satisfaction. This is the responsibilities or duty of an counter clerk. So this is information concerning job requirements. This includes the arrangement item on shelf as per the supervisor, assisting customers, provide information, rearrange distributed items, ensure item price is clearly indicated. So we can see various number of points that are required, that are concerned with the information concerning job requirements. Now we come with the job description. This is the another topic, that is, job description is an important document which basically descriptive in nature and contain a statement of job analysis. It tells us about what is to be done, how it is done, and where to perform. So it contains, like we can see, job title tells us about the job title, your code, your department. Summary includes a brief write-up about what you do all about. Job activities, a description of task, facilities used, extent of supervisory help. Working condition include the physical environment of job in terms of light, heat, noise. Social environment includes size of workforce and interpersonal interactions required to the job. Now we can see this with the help of example, like job title is marketing assistant. He is reporting to the marketing manager. His location is marketing department, Sweden. His main purpose is to plan and carry out marketing activities so as to maintain develop sales of companies products to UK customers in line with the business plans. Duties and responsibilities include so many responsibilities like plan and carry out marketing activities, agreed with budget, sales, volumes, values, product mix, time sales, develop and implement idea for marketing to my major customers, develop and produce marketing communications and press releases, plan and coordinate all trade show events, ensuring plans communicate. So these are the duties and responsibilities he need to perform while he is into this particular job. Trainings lena, computerize customer database, maintain karna, monitor करना, मार्केटिंग एक्टिविटीज़ को कैरी करना, दीज आर दी बेसिक रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी ऑफ मार्केटिंग मैनेजर. हिज स्कोप ऑफ स्केल इज दी यर, दिस इज शोन द बजट, डेटाबेस एंड नो डायरेक्ट रिपोर्ट. हिज सैलरी, दिस इज हिज सैलरी एंड बेनिफिट्स आर ऑल्सो शोन हेयर. Now we comes to the next topic, that is job set specification. As we job analysis consists of the job analysis, job description and job specification. Job specification includes the characteristics, all the human characteristics needed for a satisfactory job competition. It requires the skills, the knowledge that is required to perform the job. It can be said that the skill, education, experience, skill, knowledge, ability, KSA that is required to perform the job. The skills, the knowledge, the education that is required, that is needed for the particular job is the job analyst specification. Now we see the job specification of sales manager. Jobs like education for a sales manager includes MBA with marketing, a specialization as we require a sales manager, so it should be MBA in marketing. Experience, 5-7 years of experience in sales management with expertise, software solutions, large complex organization, expensive experience in all aspects of the superior supply relationship management. KSA, strong understanding of customers, market dynamics, requirements, handling team appropriately, proven leadership and ability to drive sales teams. Next, work orientation factors, willingness to travel. So, work in global teams, professionals, proven leadership and ability to drive sales teams. So, job specification of sales managers is his education, his experience, his KSA and work orientation factors. This all will include into the job specifications of sales manager. That's all for today. Thank you.